Hello, this is Jose Luis here at Parametric Camp, and welcome to another video where the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to ask you a question. Have you ever wanted to create an app and host the app in your computer and then give access to that app through a URL of the type myapp.mywebsite.com? Have you ever wanted to do that? Well, this is the right video to learn how to start doing that. I'm going to show you a demo. I have this little web server right here that is serving a very, very simple website on port 8123. What that means is that if I go to localhost 8123, I am serving this really simple hello parametric camp test kind of website. All right. But what if I wanted to do and configure that there's going to be a global URL that anyone from the internet can reach that is test.parametric.camp and that is going to point to the exact same place, right? How cool is this? Well, the way we're going to do this is I'm going to teach you how to create a permanent tunnel from a URL that you manage using a service called Tunnels and public host names in this with this company that is called Cloudflare. All right. Let me show you, and this is very useful because then you can connect any app that is living in your machine to anyone in the cloud or anywhere in the world. All right, let me show you how to do that. Let's get started. So like in the previous video, I have a small server, not a server. I have a small project with a very simple index file. One that if I drag into a browser, it literally just has one sentence in plain text, which is hello PCAMP text. And if you actually open a code editor, and if we drag this, you can see that it's not even HTML, it's literally just plain text. But the point of this is that I wanna have some kind of web page that I serve as an example for this work, okay? So the first thing that we need to do is to make sure that we have a local server that is serving this website so that we can connect that little server to the cloud using tunneling, which is the goal of this video. So the first thing that I'm going to do is I'm going to open a terminal in the same folder as I am, right? And then there are multiple ways of starting a local server. I have other videos for that, but I'm going to do just like a very quick version of that. So depending on whether if you're a Python person, then you can do python.module and then you can do http.server and then just state which port you want to start it in. And then if you do that, then basically Python will start a small local server on whichever folder you open that. So now if I go to localhost and then the port that I have just written, you can see that the server is serving this website. Okay. And this is important because when we do tunneling, we cannot connect files to the tunnel. We have to connect some service that serves HTTP requests. Okay. If you are more of a JavaScript or Node person, there is a global package that you can install by doing npm install HTTP server and install it globally like that. I already have it installed, so you don't need to do that yourself. I don't need to do that myself, but then you can just say HTTP server and then the port that you want to specify. So that's going to be 8123, all right? And then that will start a little server. So now if I refresh this, you can see that this same page has been served through my server, okay? Beautiful. What that means is that I have a local small server serving my website. So now what we want to do is we want to connect this service to the cloud using a permanent tunnel. Remember in the previous video, we saw how to do development tunnels or just like ad hoc, but I want to create a permanent route so that that address, that URL is managed by me and is permanent, okay? So let me show you how to do that. The provider that we're going to use for this tunneling is called Cloudflare. It's a company that provides networking services. If you have ever done check if you're a human here or whatever, it's probably done through them. It's a really nice company. The products are great. This is not sponsored. I'm not getting any money from saying this, but they have a really good tunneling service, which is what we're going to do. So if you don't have an account, you're going to register for an account and then you're going to log in. And when you log in, you're going to land in this dashboard, which is going to be empty for you, all right? In order to create a permanent tunnel of the kind somethingsomething.yourwebsite.com or whatever, you need to have yourwebsite.com linked here in Cloudflare. So there's two ways you can do that. If you already own yourwebsite.com with some other provider, you can still do what I'm going to do without even switching the domain from your provider here. What you can do is you can set Cloudflare to manage the DNS, the domain name service. Domain name service, I think it is what it is. Anyway, you can use Cloudflare to manage your DNS for the website, for the domain that you have registered somewhere else. Or you can just simplify your life and just buy a domain with Cloudflare, which will cost around $10 a year, and then just have it managed entirely here. So this, I have two examples here. This is a domain that I own with Cloudflare, and this is a domain that I own with someone else and that I manage the DNS here. So if you want to use a domain that you own somewhere else, the way you would do that is you click here, you add a domain, and then I'm going to type here Grasshopper Tutorials, which is a domain that I own somewhere else, right? As an existing domain. I'm going to continue. All right. And then Cloudflare is going to go and look, I'm going to select free. It's going to go and look at the DNS that exists already for that domain. And it's going to figure out who owns it, where is it, and what the DNS records are pointing to. I'm not going to get into the technicals of what that means, but basically when you type grasshoppertutorials.com, there is a company that receives that requests and is in charge of saying, well, if it's www, go here. If it's an email, go there. If it's the FTP, it's go somewhere else, which is everything that you can see here. And you can see that the domain, the register that I have it under is ovh.net. I don't know if showing this publicly is gonna lead to some hacking. But anyway, what this means is that you can now continue and go to the activation. And the only thing that you need to do that is a little tricky is that they're going to tell you here, Cloudflare is going to tell you that you need to go to the DNS records on the other website, in my case, OVH, and you need to substitute their DNS servers, which right now are whatever it's here, right? You need to replace them with the new DNS servers that you find here. So what that would mean is you're going to go to whoever is registering your other domain. In my case, it's OVH, but for you, it could be Namecheap, it could be GoDaddy, it could be any of those people. And from their dashboard, you're going to change the DNS records from whatever they are to this, okay? How to do that? You need to figure it out depending on your domain register. And also, you need to keep in mind that doing that switch takes some time. So it takes about anywhere between a few minutes, half an hour, and it can last all the way to 24 hours, like it was in my case. So that's why I'm not going to do it live here. So I'm just going to go back all the way to the beginning. And then once you have that done and configure, then your domain will show up here as active, okay? Which is what I did for, I'm going to remove this from Cloudflare, which is what I did for parametric.camp. I have registered that somewhere else, but the DNS is managed here in Cloudflare. Otherwise, if you really want your easy life, just buy a domain for $10 a year, okay? Cloudflare is also famous for doing domain registration at cost, so they literally charge you the cheapest it can be based on the actual international agency that does domain registration. So you can go to domain registration, register a domain, and then you search here for whatever you want, blah, 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 whatever. You find it, you swipe your credit card, and then after purchase, it will show up here. So my code, colab.org, is a domain that I own and that I purchased here in Cloudflare. All right, beautiful. So this was getting some domain managed or registered by Cloudflare. Once you are here, which it might be instant if you purchase, or it may take 24 hours if you change the DNS from somewhere else to Cloudflare, Then it's when you can set up your tunnel. Oh, real quick, before we go into the tunnel, the actual tunneling, just a reminder, if you actually don't want to do any of this and you don't want to spend money in owning a domain for a permanent tunnel, remember that you can always do a temporary tunnel and that we have already gone through that in the previous video in this series, where you can create a dev tunnel with ngrok or with Cloudflare as well. So if you want to know more about temporary and not permanent URLs for tunnels, you can check the previous video in a card that will pop up in the top corner in this video. All right. So let's move on to actually permanent tunnels. So let's create a permanent tunnel now. The way you find tunneling options is here in this menu called Zero Trust. I'm not sure why it's called Zero Trust. I don't know if it has to do with like protecting yourself from the dark network or whatever. But here in Zero Trust, under Networks, you have the options for creating tunnels. So you, as you can see here, I already have a tunnel from some other project that I'm working on. And the idea is that you have to do two things first. First, you have to work on developing, no, that's not the right word. You have to deploy a tunneling solution in a particular machine, and that is only on a per machine basis or per computer basis. And then once you have the tunnel established, then you can create as many subdomain pointers into as many different services into that machine through the same tunnel. So a tunnel and anything that you connect to that tunnel are two different things. So let's start by creating the tunnel itself. If you've never done this and this is empty for you, the way you go about this is you create your tunnel, you select here Cloudflare, and then you first give it a name. So for example, I'm going to call this, machine that I'm running it, I call it the Beast, because when I bought it, I thought it was like gigantic and it was a monster. That was many years ago, but I still use the name. Anyway, so this is the Beast desktop. I'm going to save the tunnel. And again, this is something that is specific to a particular machine or a particular laptop or a particular server, all right? Because I'm running Windows, I would choose Windows 64 bits, and then I already would get a link to a downloadable. So you download the installable, you download it somewhere on your machine, right? And then you run the installer, and what this will do is will create a Cloudflare. It will give you access to the Cloudflare daemon or the agent that in your machine takes care of handling Cloudflare stuff, basically. Once you have that, then you can see that here you have this command line instruction that you need to run that contains this here, this token. This token is the token, your secret token, the one that you will use to establish the connection between your machine and between your and between Cloudflare. So I'm going to copy this, and what I'm going to do is I'm going to open a terminal, right? And my terminal is going to be a PowerShell terminal. I just like PowerShell better, all right? I'm going to make this. And if you just install this for the first time, a good way to know if Cloudflare's installed successfully is just to type Cloudflared with a D at the end, //version. And if you get something like this, if you get a positive response, it means that Cloudflare is available and exists in your system. Make sure to open a new terminal after you install Cloudflare so that Cloudflare becomes available. All right, beautiful. So then what I'm going to do is I'm going to paste that command that I got from Cloudflare. And by doing that, what this does is that it now has connected with this secret token that I need to redo because I'm doing this publicly. With this secret token, this machine is now connected to Cloudflare, the cloud service. All right, so now we are connected. I'm going to click next. All right, and before going into this, I'm just going to go back to tunnels and make sure that this is working. So what you should see now is some kind of line that says the name of the tunnel you created, some secret tunnels, and then it should say that it's healthy. It should say that it can see your service locally, all right? If this is going well for you, then now you can go to configure, and then in configure, you can go to public hostname and start adding those routes that I was talking about. So I'm going to add a public hostname, and for this one, I'm gonna call it test, all right? Here, I'm gonna go and choose whichever domain I have already registered with Cloudflare. I'm gonna choose parametric.camp. You could choose paths. We're gonna do root here. And then what I need to do is I need to connect this to some kind of local service. I wanna remind you that we are running a local service here on localhost 3123. So this is what I need to input here. I'm going to choose HTTP, and then I'm gonna write localhost colon 8123. I'm going to save this host name right here. And you can see that now I have piped test.parametric.camp to the local service in my machine that is running on port 8123. What that means is that I should be able with any browser to now go to test.parametric.camp. And if I do this, boom, did you see that? Did you see that this request got piped from Cloudflare into this local machine, and then my local machine served this website? And what I want to highlight is that even if I'm doing this from my machine that actually has the local service running in it, the request went all the way through the Cloudflare servers and back to my machine. So if any of you are watching this video live as I am recording it right now, you can probably type on your own browser test.parametric.camp and it will show up here. We will see like some kind of action, like someone, something being served, okay? So what this means is that you have literally just opened now, and I see someone from, from the live stream probably just did this on their end, okay? So what this means is that now this subdomain and this domain will always be serving this server so long as I have the service running. If I stop this, then the request is going to land nowhere, okay? So that is how you create a permanent route. Maybe I should have written here hello tunnels or something. I don't know. But yes, so this is how you would create that kind of permanent tunnel. All right. Why is this interesting? Well, it's interesting because now you can access any kind of local service that you might be running on your machine from anywhere in the world with a very simple, very straightforward URL that you manage, right? And then that means opening up any kind of services to the entire internet, your clients, your collaborators, whatever, whatever. And in the context of this series, in this playlist, the first thing that we're gonna do is we're gonna try this out, connecting a open web UI application that is going to be running a local LLM, so that we're going to create chat.parametric.camp, and we're going to access a ChatGPT-like interface with a local LLM running on my machine. If you wanna learn more about how to do that, there will be a card popping up in the corner of this video, or it's coming up in next in this playlist, Having Fun with AI. So just stay tuned and you will be able to find the video, okay? Otherwise, just Google it. All right, thank you very much. It was a pleasure. And if you liked and you found this helpful, maybe like the video, maybe subscribe to the channel, maybe say hi on Discord, or maybe none of that. That's also fine. Whatever you want to do. All right. Thank you very much, and see you on the next video. Bye-bye.